As is customary, I will now make a brief statement about the affairs of the company. Dear shareholders, let me start with my prayers that all of you and your families continue to remain safe and healthy. God bless you. We have all gone through in the last few months the most difficult times, both in our personal and professional lives. Let me tell you, I am 72 years old, and this sort of a situation, I believe people saw during the Second World War. And that too, those who were there at that time say that this is worse than what we saw at Second World War. But as I said in my chairman's statement in the annual report, a crisis brings both a disaster and an opportunity. And here is, I'm very pleased to share with you that your management, while taking all precautions to stay away from the problems the current situation may throw up and sidestepping the dangers, if any, is equally focusing on the opportunities that will come up in the post-COVID scenario. The biggest positive your company has at present is that we, unlike our peers in the industry, are not burdened with high debt, and our cash flow position is more than comfortable. In addition, your management is taking requisite steps to cut costs and generate and conserve cash. And I think that is what gives us confidence that not only we will sail through this difficult period, we will come out as winners at the end of it. Let me also tell you the other areas your management is focusing on. They are developing scenarios for the next 2-3 years and what opportunities will arise and where do we focus and how do we benefit from the opportunities that will come in our way. All this while keeping an eye on the cash flows and the costs. It is also the wisdom of your management that we were not in the risky areas of high-end residential, retail, and commercial office space, the verticals which are suffering the most in real estate in recent times. Your management and their team is also getting used to new ways of working. Honestly, I had never imagined that one day people will buy houses on digital platform. As you know, house purchase is probably the most expensive check that you cut in your, the highest value check you cut in your lifetime. And people are buying that on the digital, this thing. And that is because of the platform, the learning the team has acquired. I'm pleased to inform you that the first 2 months of this quarter, the sales velocity has improved significantly from what we saw in the first quarter, and the team is effectively using the digital platform and technology to improve the sales. Let me share my personal views on the three segments of business your company is engaged in. Let me start with mid-premium. We are seeing a trend of customers who had put decisions on hold are now coming forward to close the deals. We saw that in Delhi, we saw that in Bangalore, we saw that in Pune, we saw that in Bombay. People who had visited our site 6, 7, 8 months ago have come back. Of course, there has been an effort on the part of the team, and people are saying we better move into new houses. And I hope that this reduction in stamp duty that we saw in the papers yesterday will also help us do that. The other trend that we are seeing is customers are considering moving into slightly larger accommodation thanks to social distancing. We've seen a lot of people both in the mid-market and the affordable upgrading from 2-bedroom to 3-bedroom and things like that. On the other hand, we are seeing many more opportunities for land acquisition, a question I'm all often asked by the shareholders. And I must tell you, at this time, we have a very healthy pipeline of land deals with us, very actively being pursued and very diligently being screened where we should go and what not do. And some of these deals are coming with approvals. One of our problems in delays has been the delays that happen, especially in Mumbai and Pune, to get approvals from the local authorities. So when you get a deal with land approvals, the time to market is considerably shortened, and the carrying cost of the land inventory is not there. We are also seeing opportunities in development management and brownfield developments, and these will also help strengthen the company's performance. As you are aware, the last financial year and sometime before that, your company primarily spent time on consolidation, sharpening its strategies, and building and improving its capabilities. All these efforts, together with the opportunities that are coming our way, will augur well for our future. Affordable housing, we feel it will be a huge growth opportunity, both in the near and long term. Your management has been putting a lot of effort, and lot is an understatement here, both in the area of design and construction technology. We are doing some path-breaking work in that area, and Arvind and his team has really done some disruptive thinking in that space. We fortunately have some land banks and are evaluating some more, so you should see a quick time to market in that area. Needless to say that this area does need government support, both in terms of financing for the flat buyers, because that market is very cost conscious and availability and things like that. And we are hoping that for affordable housing, there will be a separate set of land related regulations, which will help us go into both no development zone or restricted areas, as well as give us higher FSIs. In the IC and IC, this integrated cities and clusters, I'm actually quite optimistic. You've been reading news, and your uncle Donald has been talking, and a lot of other people have been talking, that there is going to be a clear trend towards reducing dependency on one particular country. The geopolitical situation will change, and if that happens, we will get opportunities in that area, significant opportunities. Actually, I am very pleased that the government is looking both at bringing foreign investment, manufacturing, etc., but is also focusing on import substitution. You have read that in the area of defense, I mean, right from that area of defense to the area of toy manufacturing, from the highest technology to the lowest technology. And these will provide opportunities to our IC and IC business. The good news that you have is your company has ready to move in land with all plug and play facilities in Chennai, two locations, Jaipur and origins near Ahmedabad, place called Jaisali. And I am quite optimistic about it. As you know, we were pioneers in this business, and we are also talking to some state governments of future opportunities, but we understand this is a long gestation project. So this time the financial structuring of those projects will be different to make the balance sheet light. I don't want to talk too much, but your management is very seriously looking at these opportunities. Other large opportunity that we see in the IC space is with the increase in the e-commerce, and which we have seen significant increase in the last few months. There is an increasing demand both from warehousing and logistics. And this will be an asset-light model where we will partner with people who will do this work. And so these are the opportunities. So I must say that while things are looking very bleak outside, I am very positive of where Mahindra Lifespaces will go in the next few years. and I need your support and patience. And I'm not saying it for the sake of saying it. I don't make these statements. I'm making these statements for the first time because I am, although I'm not in office remotely, I have been spending a lot of time with Arvind and the senior management. And this is all based on facts that are on the ground. Before I conclude, I want to place on record my sincere appreciation of the contribution made by Ms. Sangeeta Prasad, who resigned as MD and CEO of your company on 30th June 2020 after nearly 12 years of service. She has been indicating to me for the last few months before that her calling is somewhere else and she wants to pursue other interests in life. But I want to thank her for her contribution, and I also want to tell you that the various initiatives she took will help company in the journey towards significant growth. I, on your behalf, would like to welcome Arvind Subramaniam, a very well-respected professional who has experience both in consulting. I mentioned earlier, he was with BCG for nearly 15 years, and he ran one of the global practices. And before that, he was with Tata's, and after BCG, he was with a very large real estate developer. I am very confident that his vision and energy will take your company to much higher levels. I also want to thank you, my shareholders, for your continued support and patience, and my colleagues on the call on this meeting who have worked relentlessly for the good of the company. I want to take this opportunity to thank on your behalf and on my personal behalf thousands of corona warriors who are working relentlessly to keep us and our families safe. Big thank you to all my corona warriors, whether you're doctors, nurses, or people who are working to support their facilities. I pray once again that God bless you so that you stay safe and healthy.